and give the milk to whoever opens it. Man did as God said, and that woman, when she answered the door, said that she was praying that somebody would bring her milk all day. When was the last time that we allowed God even speaking to us as we're standing in the checkout line that go ahead and pay for so-and-so behind you? Or there's a woman over there that needs money. Why don't you just go give her X amount of dollars? Are we humble to the point that we allow God to speak to us and use us in such a manner? The next thing I find, and the last thing I find, is that Mary was a worshiper. We find that in Luke chapter 1, verses 46 through 55. If someone would please read those seven verses. Or eight verses, I guess it is. Or nine verses. I majored in history, not mathematics. But Luke chapter 1, verses 46 through 55. And if someone has that, please, someone else find Psalm 24, verses 3 and 4. Psalm 24, 3 and 4. Does anyone have Luke chapter 1, verses 46 through 55? I'll go ahead and read Luke 1, chapter 46, Luke chapter 1, verse 46 through 55. And Mary said, "My soul doth magnify the Lord, and my spirit hath rejoiced in God my Savior. For he hath regarded the low estate of his handmaiden. For behold, from henceforth all generations shall call me blessed. For he that is mighty hath done to me great things, and holy is his name. And his mercy is on them that fear him from generation to generation. He hath showed strength with his arm. He hath scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts. He hath put down the mighty from their seats, and exalted them of low degree. He hath filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he hath sent empty away. He hath holpen his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy. And he spake to our fathers, to Abraham, and to his seed forever. What is Mary doing in these verses? She's rejoicing and thanking God. She's worshiping God for what he's delivered to her, for what he's about to do. As Christians, we must worship God. But God demands a particular type of worship. What does Psalm chapter 24, verse 3 and 4 states?
Who shall ascend into the hill of the Lord? Who shall stand in his holy place? He that is clean hands and pure heart has not lifted up the soul of vanity nor sworn deceitfully.
Who is able to worship God? He that hath clean hands and a pure heart. Are all our sins buried under the blood this morning? God calls for worshipers to worship him in spirit and in truth, who've not lifted up their souls into vanity, nor sworn deceitfully. But he's looking for men and women that may worship him with a clean heart, clean hands, and worship him for who he is. Worship him for what he has done. To worship him for what he will do. God is worthy of our praise. But if we've been sinning all week, if we've been living whatever way we wanted to, doing whatever we wanted that is contrary to the word of God, our praise and our worship is unacceptable to him. Because we are not worshiping him with clean hands. We're not worshiping him with a pure heart. But God is looking for a people who have kept themselves. He's looking for a church without spot, without wrinkle. Those who have not turned by the wayside, but have kept their eyes fixated on him. those that can enter into the throne of God room and ask petitions, not because of who we are, but because of who Jesus is. Because when we confess our sins and live according to the Bible, we no longer have our righteousness on, but it's been replaced with the precious righteousness of Jesus Christ. We've talked about the high priest Joshua in weeks past, and how he stood before God Almighty in judgment with filthy rags. And the devil was there accusing him. But what happened? God came by and took his old filthy rags and gave him a new set of clothes. He put on him the righteousness of Jesus Christ that was clean, that was pure. Why? Because while our actions must reflect those of Christ, our actions must reflect those according to the Word of God. We only get to that point because we accepted Jesus Christ as a personal Savior. Those actions are not our ticket into heaven. But we do those actions because we've been covered with the precious blood of Jesus Christ. What does the Word of God state concerning those that try to get into heaven through their own works and their own deeds? It states, it's not possible. By grace are you saved, not of works, lest any man should boast. But God is calling for pure worshipers. People who can worship Him in sincerity and truth, that can come together and blend together in unity, as they did on the day of Pentecost, with one mindset and one accord, to worship God, not because of who we are, but because of who He is and the price that He paid for us. And when we come together with one mindset and one accord, the Holy Ghost can move freely like we could never dream or imagine. God can have His way with the service. Does anybody have any thoughts, any questions that they'd like to have at this point? If not, let's bow our heads and prepare our hearts for service. Gracious Heavenly Father, we give you all praise and glory because you alone are holy and worthy. Even right now, we rebuke every attack of the enemy that should come our way. We pray, Lord, that says the angels at the four corners of the property, above and below, that no attack of the enemy may penetrate. I pray that our hearts and our minds will be in one mindset, one accord, that we may worship you in sincerity and truth, that the Holy Ghost may move, make himself visible if he so chooses. Let the gifts of the Spirit be in operation today, I pray. Anoint the song leader and the musicians as they lead us in songs you have us to sing, as they guide us in worship to you, Lord, because you alone are holy and worthy. Give the musicians a special blessing as they praise you upon the string instruments and the vocal cords. Anoint the pastor as he brings forth your message today. Anoint his mind and his lips to bring forth your words. And anoint our minds and our hearts to receive the message today, to apply it to our hearts that we may grow in the Word of God, that we may be even farther transformed to the image of Jesus Christ. And even right now, Lord, we pray for the Blacklight service tonight. We pray, Lord, that you begin preparing the hearts and the minds like never before to receive your word today. And even right now, we rebuke every attack of the enemy that should come our way, every attack of the enemy that may try to make their mind and their heart stony soil, that your word may not take root or fall on it properly, Lord, that the enemy may come in and snatch like birds. Lord, we rebuke all these things in the name of Jesus. We pray that their hearts and their minds will be plowed and ready to receive your word tonight, that the kingdom of heaven may grow like never before, because that's what it's all about. Lord, that souls will be won for your sake, that they may know you like never before, because that is the whole reason that the Son of God came, to seek and to save that which is lost. I pray, Lord, even right now, Lord, that you just move in this property like never before, that there be a constant peace throughout the entire day, that the enemy may not be able to work at all, Lord, for we do not give him freedom and liberty here today, throughout the remainder of the day as well. May the Holy Ghost have such a promise that as they're coming up this hill, that they would just feel your spirit like never before, that they may say truly the presence of the Lord was in this place. We ask all these things in the name of Jesus. Amen.